What up, though? This is Big Snoop Dogg, and you're watching Fuse on Demand. Get it when you want it.
Now, you have fans out there that's requesting, that's begging, when can we get that 90s feel? And what they mean by that is, when can we get a real album out here?
Yo, I be like Iggy, yes, y'all. Doctor on call, I rock to my name and graffiti on the wall. Got flow like the rappers in Great George. I got my name Jamal, I pause.
The 90s era was more of, you have to have an album. You have to be lyrically to be on top. You had to have ground. You just can't come out the woodworks with a new single and be the man like you can now. The concepts that people talked about from the 90s to now, it was more of a who I am and what I'm about back in the 90s. And this is what I believe in. Now is more of like, you know, I get this, I got that. And I think everybody can understand that. It's cool. And I'm not saying that the new era of MCs are not doing hip-hop, because I can never say that. They're young. I think they're doing a great job of keeping the money and the revenue going for hip-hop. But I just think it's missing a tad bit of the concept in doing the album. That's it. A little more essence, a little more hip-hop essence need to be involved. It's like you hear one song on the radio 80 times a day, and it's like you're going to buy that album for that one song. Remember back in the 90s or even like the late 80s when you had a tape and it wasn't about the single that was being played on the air. It was always about having that certain song that nobody heard, and you like, yeah, you ain't got this or that. That little era has, I think, disappeared, where you wanted to find something that was so gritty that wasn't on the radio, whereas to now, everything is on the radio that you want to be attached to, or you have to be attached to. With me and Meth in the studio, it's like we got a little system. I always been a studio bunny. Like, I spend like 12, 15 hours a day in the studio. I learned to engineer as well. I try to learn everything in the studio to operate. If it's any machine in the studio, I know how to operate it. And Meth respects me on that, and he know I got good judgment. So now I'm actually engineering our sessions, and I'm actually giving direction what we should do or feel, taking it to mastering, taking it to get mixed and the whole nine. So it's really like a system we got. We can't really explain. He just trusts me for what I do, and I trust him for what he do. As far as like me and him, when we do it, we sit down and listen to the beat. Try to get a concept about it first. Try to get the hook first, so we don't be just writing raps all over the place, because that's what we did in the 90s. We just rap. So now it's like we're grown now. We have to have concept. And we sit down, get the hook, get the concept, and it's on out the door. That's how we did the whole album. We actually did the album like a mixtape, so. Real easy, real fun. Well, Meth write his lyrics, I write my lyrics. Life is inspiration to me. Music is my first love. Traveling on a plane, I might be on a plane, I might catch a nice song from the plane music. You know when you're born and they got the, you know, I can see clearly now. I'm like, oh, shit, I'm about to go somewhere and I'm hearing this. I might get on a pen and write some hot shit down. The box that we are in. We know we ain't come out in 10 years. So it's like, you know, they probably expected us to be on a new wave. You know, having artists, having the auto-tune going flying. Yeah, we got auto-tune to let you know how we can dabble in it. But the one thing that stands out about this album to me is that the beats we chose, the feel of it is a 90s feel.
Hell, hell, yo, hell. I got my swagger on and I feel great. Funk Doc be in the hood like infamil cases. I network on MySpace real late, hoping my Apple make me another Bill Gates.
It's something that's missing right now. It's so much keyboard beats. Not too many people use the samples. We use samples. Like I said, I think people will appreciate this for that. Just that, off the bat. Besides us having dope songs and our lyrical game stepped up a whole notch, just the whole fact that, like, yeah, this is what the been missing. Energy, fun. On here like this. the first album with Red and Meth, it was more of an Eric Sermon, RZA feel. They had more, most of the tracks. It was all family, put it that way. This album we reached out. Then we got Benny Idol, Havoc from Mobb Deep, Top Fight from Queens, Eric Sermon, Rockwalla, of course, Mathematics, Pete Rock, my man Nasty Cuts from overseas, Buck Wow, Bink. I didn't even know we had that many. DJ Scratch, this other kid called Swift from LA. We just wanted to reach out to other producers this time. We didn't want to put that stress on E and RZA to get it done. What particular track stands out to Redman off the album? Jeez, why would you do that? With all those producers on there, why would you do that? But you know what? I gotta keep it funky. Father's Day, my man Top Fife. I like that because it's soulful. I love Mary J from Door One. We started around the same time. She just took off and just, she's fabulous to me. Jamiroquai, I think he's very interesting. I need him to come back with it, but loved his music. I think he was way out to the left and a lot of people couldn't dig that, but I dug it. And Jill Scott, fabulous woman, fabulous woman. She's just so on it with her music and her vibe is so strong that it sucks you in. And even from her first album, I was like, wow, she's incredible to me. I always wanted to do a record with her. That we're I get that a lot because, not that I'm a like, when I meet people, when I meet fans, I try to be as nice as possible. I ain't gonna lie, like, you know, I'm not 100% nice all day. I might have a bad day with a fan here and there. And they have to understand, like, majority of the times, 90% of the times, I'm hey, pitch it, come on, get it. My last goal is to go to school to be a dental hygienist. I want to clean people's teeth. I know when I go get my teeth cleaned, the lady who cleans my teeth has me in that chair crying. I'm not a really handy brushman, but I look at my mouth and I feel the pain. And then I go to the hood and I look at my boy's ragged mouth. I'd be like, shit, I know if they was in that chair, they'd be falling out. So I wanna be a dental hygienist where I can actually open something up in my community where people that might not have insurance or whatever. Well, I can just charge them. Come in and get your teeth cleaned, man. You know, a smile goes a long way. You know, when you open your mouth, your words, your everything speaks from you from there. And that has to be solid. You can't be going in a meeting with a rotten mouth. So, you know, that's where I'm headed to.